Julia forgot her her ID. We're actually part of going to the wine tasting, so you need an ID for to drink wine, and Morin forgot it. It's okay. All right, ready? Now we're gonna go actually drink some wine and get drunk. Mm-hmm. Okay, so guys wanna follow us to get some wine?
Oh.
Let's go. Cheers.
Castillo
de Amarosa.
Amarosa.
So as a part-time, what do you want to do?
You
said first. Actually, as a part-time, now that I'm drinking wine, I actually want to be like a part-time bartender.
So you can make cocktails.
Yeah, make cocktails. I think it's sort of a cool hobby because, you know, it's cool to drink and then cool to make alcohol for different people. And being a bartender is actually you get to experiment with a lot of drinks.
Well, so you're more interested in drinks, not people.
I think as a bartender, you get to make the drinks. You get to experiment. And also, at the same time, you get to socialize with different people. Good, like, atmosphere to meet new people, talk with different people from different backgrounds.
Yeah, because I was thinking for people who need to do business trips a lot, we have to go to different places to do different work. That's fine, but for bartender, they stay in one block, like one specific place, but not forever, but for their entire job. Mm-hmm. But they get to see different worlds through people.
Yeah. What do you want to be as a part-time?
Want to be a freelance artist.
Freelance artist, like what?
Like creating different scenes. Like random scenes and then just sell it. So basically I want to own a store. Maybe Monday I sell books, Tuesday I serve food, Thursday I serve drinks, Friday I serve art pieces, and Saturday I serve like knowledge.
So do you own like a studio or a restaurant or something? How do you sell all those things? Monday through Fridays.
Yeah, so like one place, but it just changed the interior every day. Sunday can be a winery place. Mm.
So you're like WeWork, you know? Actually, I thought about that before.
Really?
It's like using one room and change it to cater to the customer need. It's like a pop-up, like a pop-up of events.
Oh, yeah.
So in San Francisco, there's like a lot of pop-up events this venue is only there for like 2 or 3 months. And then after that, it becomes vacant. So the last year was Candytopia, where they have a pop-up to have candy. This year, they actually called Hooptopia. You know what Hooptopia is?
No.
It's for basketball, to experience Golden State Warriors.
So like museum?
Kind of museum, yeah. You get to do like autographs, you get to do graffiti. So basically what Julia wants to do.
A quicker version of pop-up. Some pop-up places, they're like, a month for a season. I'm thinking about like 4 days.
And then every day of the week can be something different. Like Monday would be, what is it?
A bookstore.
A bookstore. Second day?
A restaurant.
Wow. Third day?
A winery.
Fourth day?
Massage. Salmon.
So I'm actually gonna
get this. What is this?
This is one of the wines. So I'm gonna
bring
this.
You don't know what it is,
actually,
right?
No, this is a Fantasia.
You just got it. For this case.
Yeah. It's actually cool. This is one of the best sellers. So I'm gonna take this
I feel like you're at a toy store. Yeah. Like I'm gonna get this toy.
This is the Lego store. I'm keeping this and then I'll give my parents the national park. I'm keeping this one.
But what are you gonna just put it at home?
Yeah, put it at home.
Stupid.
It's good.
Stupid.
Best seller. Now we're gonna go back to Times Square, so thanks for watching our channel. Be sure to subscribe and comment 分享和什么
subscribe
好的 好下次有期 是吗
下会后会有期